Hi, this is Waylon from Marine Depot. Today we're taking a look at ion exchange resins. We'll discuss if they're helpful for keeping your water clean in a saltwater aquarium. There has always been confusion and a bit of skepticism about using ion exchange resins in saltwater aquariums. The truth is, most resins don't work at all in saltwater. But there are some specialty resins that can greatly improve water quality in a reef tank. We'll explain why this is and how to select resin-based filter media that will really work in your aquarium. The first resin-based aquarium filtration product was introduced to the hobby in the 1960s. It's important to understand what ion exchange resins are, how they work, and why you would consider using them in your saltwater aquarium. Typical resin beads are about 1 millimeter in size and are made from either acrylic or polystyrene. When manufactured, the resin goes through one or more chemical treatments to create custom ion exchange sites located throughout the bead. Resins with different properties are created by altering the chemical treatments used to manufacture the resin beads. For example, some resins are made for water softeners, the removal of calcium and magnesium from the water. You'll find these in residential homes and hotels. A different process creates resins that remove nitrate from drinking water. You may be thinking any nitrate removing resin will be great for a reef tank. It sounds like a great idea, but it won't actually work, and here's why. Ion exchange resins work by trading one ion for another. Let's look at a water softening resin. The resin has a negative charge that attracts positive ions. Positive ions are also known as cations. It's called a cation exchange resin because positive ions in the resin are exchanged with other cations in the water. The manufacturer loads softening resin with sodium ions. As fresh water flows through a bed of resin, the sodium ions are exchanged for calcium and magnesium. Water hardness is removed and the sodium is released. Once the exchange capacity of softening resin is exhausted, it's flushed with salt water, which is why you add salt to a water softener. This strips off the hardness minerals and reloads the resin with sodium ions. But what happens if this resin was used in a reef aquarium? Would it actually remove calcium and magnesium? No, it won't remove anything because aquarium salt water is too high in sodium ions. The exchange process won't work due to the high sodium content of the salt water. A similar principle occurs with nitrate removing resin. Anion resin has a positive charge and attracts negatively charged ions, also known as anions. The resin is loaded with chloride ions by the manufacturer. As fresh water passes through the bed of resin, the resin trades chloride ions for nitrate ions. The resin is recharged with salt to remove the nitrate and replenish the resin with chloride. But the resin cannot exchange ions in salt water because the chloride level is too high. The exchange can't occur. Unfortunately, many of these typical resins have been offered to the marine hobby along with inaccurate claims of ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate removal. As we've just seen, standard resins just won't work in salt water. Fortunately, there are specialty resins that do actually function well in salt water. They're called organic scavenger resins. They're made specifically for saltwater aquariums. These unique resins have a porous structure designed to capture dissolved organic compounds. The manufacturing process creates a highly specific porous internal network with specific absorption characteristics that don't rely on ion exchange process. Resin manufacturers fine-tune the absorption properties of resins for specific applications like decoloring sugar and tannin removal from drinking water. There are many scavenger resins, but not all are effective in saltwater aquariums. The best scavenger resins capture both medium and long-chain organics responsible for the discoloration of water. You can actually see the resin turn brown as our organics are trapped inside the beads. Fresh scavenger resins are white, clear, or amber in color. They'll turn tan or brown as organics are captured and concentrated inside the resin beads. You may be wondering what the difference is between activated carbon and organic scavenger resins. Resin-based filter media are more expensive, but you're getting a more efficient filter media designed to remove organics like those that build up in our aquariums. Unpublished research by an aquarium product manufacturer found that certain scavenger resins, when combined with coal-based activated carbon, work better than resin alone or carbon alone. The same resin blend was found to be highly effective for removing organics from the groundwater by water treatment facilities. You can also use a resin-based media without carbon. Just pour it into a filter bag and drop it into your sump or your filter. Also, some resins are able to be regenerated at home. There are a variety of carbon resin products to choose from. The performance of each brand will depend on the type and amount of resin blended with activated carbon. The label should state that it contains specialty scavenger resins that remove organics. If you're having an issue with phosphate, nitrate, or algae growth, a resin-based media can help. The organics removed from the water won't have a chance to break down and form algae-producing nutrients. The best advice is to experiment with different brands. Look for clearer water and better light penetration. If you have any questions, feel free to message us on social media or give our excellent customer service team a call. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below. Thank you for watching our video today. And as always, let's build a better aquarium together.